So I'm Roman Gojaev. I'm coming from Azerbaijan, and this is my friend Ihita. She's coming from India. We both are Generation Connect Visionaries Board of ITU, which is youth board for digital inclusion. And by the way, Ihita came here after 25 hours long flight, and I wonder why you are here. What brings you here, Ihita?
Well, that was definitely a really long journey to get here. And so did you travel a lot. But we are here today to bring to the center stage the voices of the youth, you know, share their experiences, perspectives, and ideas on accelerating SDGs. You know what? There was a research that happened wherein young people were involved, where they highlighted the importance and potential of emerging technologies such as AI, IoT, GIS, AR, and VR to accelerate SDGs and express some of their concerns.
Well, that sounds amazing, isn't it? I wonder if there are any solutions that young people want to bring for these concerns.
Oh yeah, they highlighted several applications. They illustrated how technology, for instance, IoT can be used in environment monitoring to monitor and track the environmental parameters to improve the quality of air and water. Similarly, the use of AR and VR for achieving healthcare and quality education.
I know, right? Another northwards technology I've heard from young people is remote sensing technology. So these tools have provided significant impact for critical aspects such as soil water or monitoring of land use. And young people say that there is potential significance of these tools for the farmers in agriculture especially. But there is also emphasized that the potential of these applications still remain untapped.
Well, there are definitely a lot of applications out there and a lot of innovative ideas. But Roman, why are these untapped?
So my answer will be governmental willingness and youth participation, because young individuals expect decision makers to involve them, for them to be part of the decision-making processes. And they're also expecting the stakeholders across private, public, and social sphere to empower them being digital change makers in their communities, because they are the ones facing these challenges in their communities, right? And they are actually also saying that there should be investment made in localizing digital solutions, making it accessible in their local languages.
That's a great point. You know, having worked with and conducted research myself in IoT and various other emerging technologies, and in the technology and policy and standards space, I can see that establishing forward-looking regulatory mechanisms and frameworks that encompass data protection, data privacy laws, and technology-specific regulation is important. For example, in AI.
You see, exactly. Like, immediate action taken by the decision makers could be focused on equitable access also for the quality education and also gender digital divide.
Hold on. And what does it mean, gender digital divide?
Okay. So that is different. So there is basically a digital divide that impacts women especially when it comes to the geography, once it comes to the economic issues. And there's also a large proportion of youth, especially young girls, who doesn't have any access to internet or any kind of technologies. So this results in absence of equality of opportunities for education and, of course, financial independence.
Well, as a youth and a young woman myself, I can totally relate to this and I understand. So raising awareness and understanding of SDGs within the societies is really important. It's important to prioritize SDGs at a national level to integrate them into our policies and frameworks across sectors. And we should assemble youth to take it forward.
Yeah, thank you for sharing. And right, what we should now, I see at least 500 people here in the room. Do you see me? You should. And I want you to clap if you agree with us. I want to hear from you. More.
Thank you.
Thank you. See ya.
Thank you so much.